University of Arkansas System, Division of Agriculture Scientists, offered the latest in edamame research during a field day at the Vegetable Research Station near Alma.
We have three tests here. They're all concerned about preserving seed quality, either through identifying resistance to fungal pathogens or the use of fungicides to protect the seed. This year, we lucked out and we got straw guy leaf spot, a foliar pathogen. It's becoming more important in the last few years. And we were able to get some good efficacy data on that. The best fungicide we had was Alto, which is a cyproconazole. It's a triazole. It was quite effective. What's important about that is the other class of fungicides we have, the strobilurins, things like headline and quadris, this fungus, the frog eye leaf spot pathogen, has developed resistance to. We don't know whether the isolates we got from this field are resistant, but we know in eastern Arkansas there are a number of counties that have resistant strains of that. So that makes those fungicides ineffective against frog eye. So having another class of fungicide available for control is pretty important.
Industry experts were on hand to answer questions, present reports on their research, and to announce new developments at the JYC Foods soybean processing plant.
This is one of the new products that we developed. This one actually still uses China edamame because we don't have a freeze-drying facility here yet in Arkansas, but this is a freeze-dried edamame. And when you freeze-dry something, you preserve the nutrients and the protein and all the vitamins, and it also preserves the flavor and the color. And we found that there are quite a number of people that really enjoy this, and we added flavoring to it to make it a nice portable snack. And we're selling it all over stores across the U.S. and actually exporting it too already. We're exporting it to Asia. A big customer in Australia wants it too as well. So this is just a tip of the iceberg, though. There are a lot of other things we can do with this. You know, edamame fundamentally is soybeans, right? And so it's a very versatile crop that we can do a lot with. So,
Ray, that product, though, that is put together there in Mulberry.
That's right. This is we just get the raw materials, the freeze-dried edamame from China. All the other ingredients, the seasonings, the oil, they're sourced in the U.S. and we do all the quality control, all the seasoning and packaging in Mulberry. You know, the most important thing that has really allowed us to succeed here is really the support we've gotten from growers, as well as the state and the university. And the state has provided us with the financing for the plant, and they just approved another financing, $3.6 million, and we're going to use that to expand the plant, and should get that done by hopefully beginning of next year and ready for the next season.
We're going to be craft raising them?
We're going to be drying them. Freeze dry, there's another process I'm looking at too that could be pretty interesting.